Hello everyone, welcome to Semiconductor. Today, let's talk about solder ball. Solder ball is a small ball-shaped solder attached on the bottom of package substrate. Then connect package substrate and PCB during the SMT process. Usually, BGA, CSP, and flip chip package use solder ball. It has many different sizes and alloy by its applications. It is packaged in a jar, and jar can be glass or plastic. Typically, solder ball size is from 150 micrometers to 750 micrometers, but for some cases, it can be larger or smaller as well. Major suppliers are Senju from Japan, Alpha from US, Ducksan and MKE from Korea. There are two major methods of ball forming process. One is cutting and the other is atomizing. For cutting, it starts from solder wire cutting. And it goes through melting zone and spear zone, then cooling zone. Solder ball size is determined by solder chip volume. For atomizing, it starts with melting solder bar in the furnace, and specific amount of molten solder, which is controlled by exciter, is released, then enters into low velocity zone. After that, it goes through spear zone and cooling zone. Solder ball size is determined by frequency and nozzle diameters. After this ball forming process, there are many following processes like surface cleaning, drying, sieving, sorting, classifying, final inspection, and packing and delivery. There are two major categories in solder ball composition. One is lead and the other one is lead-free. Lead-containing solder is popular in electronics thanks for its low temperature and low cost because it is abundant. Especially tin lead eutectic solder is one of the most popular solder alloy with 183 degrees C melting temperature. But people realize its toxicity, so phase-out procedure is in progress. An alternative of lead solder without toxicity is lead-free solder. It does not have lead, and SEC 305 is one of the most popular lead-free solder in the industry. Actually, lead solder and lead-free solder looks different. I couldn't find solderable photo, but this one is enough to explain. If you check solderable with microscope, surface of lead solderable looks shiny, but lead-free solderable looks matte. This way, you can find which one is lead and which one is lead-free solderable. There are lots of different solderable alloy, and here are some examples. SEC 305 has 96.5% tin, 3% silver, and 0.5% copper, and it is industry standard lead-free solderable. In general, lead-free solder has higher melting temperature than lead solder, and solder alloy with bismuth has lower melting temperature than others. But usually, it is more expensive. Some alloy shows better drop shot reliability, which is important for smartphone application. There are some special solderables, copper core solderable and plastic core solderable. Copper core solderable has copper core at the center and nickel plating layer at the middle and solder plating layer at the surface. It is used for Shinko MSAP, package on package, and due to high melting temperature of copper, 1085 degrees C, copper core solder ball will not collapse during reflow process and can keep space. Plastic core solder ball has plastic core and it relaxes mechanical stress and can improve reliability performance like temperature cycling and drop test. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye bye.